Hi, I'm Lauren. I'll be your nurse today. I'm going to teach you how to take care of your catheter at home. I'm going to give you teaching sheets with step-by-step instructions. You'll have the teaching sheets as a reference when you go home. Mm-hmm. Have a clean work area for all of your materials. Move away all clutter and wash the area with a disinfectant wipe. I'm going to do that for our area now. Good. Now our area is nice and clean. First, I want to show you a clave. A clave is a connector that is attached to the end of your central line. It may come in a variety of styles or colors, but this is what our clave is going to look like for today. Next, this is a disinfecting cap. It contains a small amount of alcohol or another anti-infection product inside of it. It is used to cover the end of the clave when it's not in use. Each lumen of your Hickman line needs to be flushed with normal saline. How many lumens does your Hickman have?
I have two.
Two. So that means we need two saline flushes, two disinfecting caps,
gloves, and two alcohol wipes.
Okay.
During this process, you'll see I wash my hands a lot, and this is going to help prevent any infection.
Okay.
While I do this, could you unbutton your shirt and take your catheter out? We want to visualize the clamps on your tubing. So I'm glad to see that both of your lumens have the clamps closed. You've closed the clamps on the designated area on each lumen that's marked with clamped here. This is a thicker part of the catheter that can withstand the clamp being closed on it. It's important to note that every time you open up the clamp, you should move the clamp down or up a little bit so you're not hitting the exact same spot every time. Make sure that you aren't clamping on this thinner portion of the catheter because it could cause the catheter to break or damage. So now that my hands are clean and I have clean gloves on, we're going to flush your lumens. First, we need to prepare the saline flush. These saline flushes come individually packaged. I'm going to open it up. As you can see, there's a little air in the syringe. We want to get that air out. Sometimes you may need to tap the syringe to get all the air up at the top. Make sure that the plunger is pointing down. You can take off the cap of the syringe, making sure that you don't touch the top of the syringe. You don't want to make that dirty. And then you can gently push out the air bubble until the saline's to the top of the syringe.
What happens if some of the saline gets out?
If some of the saline gets out, that's okay. You can still use the syringe for your flush. And now I'm going to get my alcohol swab. I'm going to start with the red lumen. I'll take off the disinfectant cap, and with my alcohol swab, I'm going to vigorously scrub the top for at least 10 seconds. I like to count to 10. 8, 9, 10. That's really important to ensure that you don't get an infection.
What if I touch the cap by accident?
If you accidentally touch the cap after you've cleaned it, you'll need to get another alcohol swab and clean again.
Okay.
Right. While I'm holding the clave, I'm going to push the syringe into the top of the clave, and I'm going to turn clockwise to make sure that the syringe is connected to that clave. Make sure that you open up the clamp, because you won't be able to flush if that clamp is closed. And we're going to do what's called a pulsatile flush. That's when I'm going to push in 1 mL of saline and pause for about a second, and then I'll push the next ml and pause. You're going to do this until the entire syringe has flushed through the lumen.
How much is a 1 mL?
Oh, that's a great question. So 1 mL is 1 mL. On the side of the syringe, you can see that it's broken up into 10 mL of fluid. So you can easily monitor pushing in 1 mL at a time and then pausing.
Okay.
You'll continue this until the flush is completely flushed into the lumen. Once that is done, you want to make sure that you reclamp the line. Like I mentioned earlier, you can move the clamp very slightly to ensure that you're not hitting the same spot every time, and then clamp it. Disconnect the syringe by turning counterclockwise, And then you can get a clean disinfectant cap and put it on the end of the clave.
Okay.
Next, I would like you to flush the second lumen. So now that the red line is flushed, it's time to flush the white line. Sometimes a little trick I have for remembering which line to flush is I'll do red, white, and blue. So I start with my red, then I go to the white line, and some people have three lumens, they'll have a blue lumen. So that helps me remember which one's done.
Can I leave the syringe attached so I know which one is done, and that way I won't get confused as to what one is not done?
Yeah, I think that's a wonderful idea. Just make sure that while the syringe is attached, it's not putting pressure or pulling at the line while you're completing it.
Okay. How often do I have to do this?
So flushes need to be done daily. Sometimes keeping a routine, like flushing first thing in the morning before breakfast, will help you remember to flush your line. But the flushes should be done every day.
If I'm coming to clinic, do I still need to flush?
No, that can be your off day. So when you're coming into clinic, if you're going to see a nurse or have treatment or anything and they're flushing that line, that will count as the flush for the day.
Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
After you open the clamp, if you have any trouble flushing in the saline, if you're feeling resistance at all, and you know that the clamp is open, don't try to force the flush in. If you are having resistance, stop the flushing process and contact your medical team for advice.
Okay.
You might need to come into the clinic to have the line assessed, or if you have a visiting nurse, they might need to come and check on it.
Okay.
Great push and pause technique. I like the way that when you took the syringe off, you held on to that blue clave to make sure that the blue clave didn't come off the end. You're doing wonderful.
Thank you.